You want to get better at photography, art, or anything creative, keeping a commonplace book is one of the most important things you can do. Like me, in the past, you may have had a lot of floating journals, where you'd have something to write in, but they weren't exactly dedicated places for learning, developing ideas, and compiling knowledge. That's what a commonplace book is. Now, there are no rules to keeping a commonplace book. You could have one specifically for the craft itself, or like me, you can have one for just life in general. But today I'm going to share with you guys different ways you can keep a commonplace book from my current perspective as a photographer. Compiling knowledge specific to you, a personal textbook. Imagine you had a textbook that was perfectly curated towards your life, your struggles, the things you needed to learn, and the obstacles you had to overcome. That's what I like to think of a commonplace book as. A commonplace book acts as a storage bin of knowledge and information that you accumulate along your journey. It has everything from things you're interested in to things you've learned or problems you face, which might mean writing things down from podcasts, books, or just something random you thought about when you were out on a walk. It's like having a personal textbook. A more specific example would be something like color grading in photography. Say I want to bring out the vibrancy and color of this sunset without breaking the image apart. I can play around with the sliders and figure out how to do so as I edit dozens and dozens of photos. And as I do so, I can write down the methods that I've learned and alternative methods of reaching the same kind of conclusion in my commonplace book. This allows me to save and store the knowledge for later as sort of a reference. Now, I can do this over the course of my photography journey as I learn new things, edit in different styles, and accumulate different bits of knowledge. So the big reason why I would recommend to do this and write this in your own commonplace book is because it allows you to write down little specific nuances towards your specific creative process. This is stuff you won't find in YouTube tutorials or forums online because everyone's photography and style is a little bit different, so it's important to write and curate that towards your own style. Another thing you can try is to write down something interesting that you've noticed someone else do in their own photography that you might want to try and apply to yours in the future. Maybe you came across an Ansel Adams photo the other day and you want to integrate elements of his black and white tones into your photography. Or maybe just the way he captures landscapes and composes his landscapes that you might want to try when you go out to the mountains in the future. Simply writing this stuff down will make it more likely for you to remember and apply these things in the future. If you need a key tip on what to write down in your commonplace book, ask yourself, is this useful? Anything useful gets written down, anything useless gets ignored. And so what's useful for you specifically will be different from other people. You determine what's useful, you determine what's worth writing down. Page after page, you'll begin to accumulate knowledge and build your own personal textbook. As you do so, your photography will improve, your knowledge as a photographer will grow, and you'll begin to understand yourself as a photographer more. Which brings me into sort of the next point. Learn what kind of photographer you are. As you progress in photography, it's important to understand what you like, what you don't like, and how you do things. One of the things to write down in your commonplace book are notes about your own creative process. Some simple questions you can ask yourself are, do I like walking around nature capturing epic landscapes, or do I prefer setting up portrait shots and taking pictures of other people? What is it about this lens or focal length that I like or don't like? And as we write, we begin to accumulate documentation of our own personal preferences in the way we go about things. So this is a good way to be honest with ourselves, and you might also notice a certain pattern developing in your own photography. This can help point the next step in your journey, whether it be picking up a new lens or deciding to build a photo book. I've noticed this myself when writing in my own commonplace book. For a long time, my favorite focal length was the 23mm or 35 equivalent, and it still is, but as I continue to take more photos of places that are further away, I start finding myself looking into more telephoto type lenses. This is something I'm interested in that I might end up delving further into as I grow in photography. Similarly, when I release prints, I like to put out photos that I've delved into purely out of my own interests, which might not necessarily be something that other people would prefer to have on their walls. For example, there's a print called Lunar Purple that was something I took earlier this year that really I color graded and color edited to have this really insane purple color cast on it. And this is not something you do in traditional photography because why would you have such a blatantly obvious color cast? It doesn't look real, it doesn't make sense. But really, I just allowed myself to follow my instincts. I thought it would look good and it was something sort of artistic I wanted to experiment with. And surprisingly, many people actually like this photo. A lot of people actually end up purchasing this print from me. And so because of things like this, I like to try and follow my intuition and to keep that place of experimentation open for exploration. Sometimes it leads me down a rocky path, but other times it can lead to happy accidents like this. So you can apply this to your own photography as well. When you go out and take photos, pay attention to what you do and why you do it. and write those things down. What did you notice about this certain place that stood out to you? Is there a better way you can frame this that could potentially give you a better end result? Try and keep these possibilities open, experiment, try new things, and don't box yourself in. Know what worked and what didn't work, and you'll notice yourself becoming more and more refined in your photography as you go. Get to the truth of things. Every now and then, I'll reread some of my older commonplace books and recopy some of the useful notes into the new ones. This is because I just write a lot of stuff down in general, and some of that stuff just isn't useful or relevant later. And so what's interesting is that I like to see what stands out to me 6 months later, or even a year later or more, and to note those things down because it allows me to observe certain patterns in the things that I write down of what might be important and what might not be important. So if something keeps popping up over and over again, and I find myself writing that thing down, that's how I know it's important. This might mean anything from problems I'm having to just helpful reminders that I think I still need. It allows me to keep track of what's actually useful or not. For example, one of the things I've noticed that keeps repeating itself is to not take myself so serious. You could probably tell in some of my past videos, but I've mentioned it from time to time as well, because photography is something I'm fairly passionate about. Whenever I'm doing anything like this, from YouTube to photography, if I'm going to do it, I might as well do it well in the first place. And so that kind of mindset forces me to think more deeply or more detail-oriented or more serious about what I'm doing. And this can be great when I'm trying to get better or improve at something, but it can cause me problems down the road because it makes the grip on the steering wheel kind of tight. And so I'll have to constantly remind myself to relax and just not take it so seriously. It's just photography. Of course, I'll still put in the work, effort, and time in, but it's not a matter of life or death, and that constant reminder is something that helps me along the way. Which, not everyone has that problem. Most people are pretty chill about photography, but this is just an example of something that keeps popping up for me, and you'll have to find those things, those little nuances that stand out to you that you find to be helpful to remind yourself of later. So if you find yourself writing something down over and over again, start highlighting a circle, starring that thing. Chances are those things that keep popping up are things that are specific to you, your problems, your life, and where you're going. And it's important to note those things down such that you'll have that in your back pocket. Then when problems do come up, you got it. See our own progress. So I find often in life, it's easy to forget how far we've come and how much we've learned. So something I've noticed when I go back and reread my commonplace book is that I actually get a lot of perspective. I get to see and feel what I was thinking of at the time, the things I was dealing with and the problems I had. And even if it's just a few months ago, I'll find myself looking back and being like, oh wow, I was so naive back then. The problems I might have had that seemed so big before seems so silly now. And so I find that to be a very useful application of commonplace books, is to get in your head and see the texture of your mind or brain at different periods or stages in your life. It's a great way to remind yourself of the progress you've made and how far you've come. And this is because progress really does take time, and you don't feel that in the present. And so you can get dejected, and it can be hard to feel patient and be patient. But if you can look back and see how much progress you've made in just the past month or so, I think this can motivate us and incentivize us to keep going and to stay strong, in a sense. So this is all big picture stuff, but it all really does add up day by day. And so if you're struggling or thinking about why or if you should keep a commonplace book, I'd greatly recommend it. I'd recommend you try it out and see if it changes your life or not. Hopefully this video could grant you some insights on how you can take what I've learned and apply it to your own photography or even just writing. Also, I'm currently giving out free 4x6 prints. If you're interested, the link is down below. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. Peace.